With SST, you define all the resources that your app needs in your SST config, and it then uses that to go off and create these resources in your cloud provider. But we explicitly tell you not to modify these resources through your AWS console or through whatever cloud provider you're using. In this video, we're going to take a look at how SST manages your resources and why you should not be modifying them directly. To start with, I have a very simple SST app. All it has is a SST function. I have this function deployed. And if I go over to the AWS console, you can see the same function that I have created, and it has a timeout of 20 seconds. Now I'm gonna go ahead and change that timeout. I'm gonna set it to something like 2 minutes, and I'm gonna run deploy. Once it's done deploying here, I can head over to the AWS console, refresh it, and see that the timeout's been updated to 2 minutes. A common question we get is, how do I tell SST to just apply the changes that I've made in my config and not recreate all the other resources? The way this works is SST keeps a state of all the resources in your app. This is saved locally, and then it gets uploaded to an S3 bucket in your AWS account. And so when you make a change, it generates a diff and notices in this case that the timeout property is the one that's changed. It then makes a call to the AWS API and just applies those changes. Now we can take a look at these changes and the state in the SST console. So if I head over to my app here and the stage that I have, you'll notice here's my function. And within the function, I have my Lambda function. If I go all the way down, you'll notice for the timeout, I have 120 seconds or 2 minutes. Now let's look at why you shouldn't make changes to your resources directly. I'm going to do the thing that we shouldn't be doing. I'm going to head over to the AWS console. I'm going to change the timeout. So instead of 2 minutes, let's go with 1 minute. And you can see the timeout is set to 1 minute. If I go back to the SST console, I'm just going to refresh it. It still thinks it's 120 seconds or 2 minutes. If I go into my SST app and I try and deploy it, you'll notice it'll say it hasn't found any changes. Just to sort of verify that again, if I go back to my SST console, again, still 2 minutes. And if I go into my AWS console, it's still 1 minute. So here's a case where your resources, the ones in the AWS console, are now out of sync with your SST app. Your SST app thinks the timeout is 2 minutes, but in reality, it's actually 1 minute. This thing can be fixed here. You can run what's called the SST refresh command. We're going to do that here. What the SST refresh command does is it looks at your state and takes every single resource in your state and compares it to what's in AWS or in your cloud provider. And then if it notices any differences, it updates your state. So in this case, it'll look at that function. It'll notice that the timeout's actually 1 minute, and it'll update your state to reflect that. And we can go see that. So if I head over to the SST console again, oh, you'll notice it's updated to 60 seconds or 1 minute. Note, what it does not do is it does not update the resources themselves. The changes are only one way. It only updates your state. So now if I go in and run deploy, you'll notice that the function was updated. So if I go back to the AWS console, or let's stop at the SST console first, again, the timeout is set to 2 minutes because that's what our config says. And now if I refresh the AWS console, it shows that it's set to 2 minutes. And now the resources in AWS and in our state and in our SST config are all back in sync again. Let's look at one more case here just to illustrate why you should not modify this and why these out of sync issues can get a little hairy to sort of deal with. I'm going to go in and I'm going to delete this function. Now I'm going to make a change to my config, pretend like the SST config does not know that something's happened. I'm going to update the timeout. I'm going to run a deploy, and I get this resource not found exception. It's basically saying that it can't find this Lambda function that's expecting to find in AWS. Now to fix this, you might be tempted to run refresh just like before. But even though refresh succeeded, what it is actually doing is it's removing the Lambda function from the state. So if I go back to my SST console, it can't find that Lambda function anymore. And if I go into my AWS console, my Lambda function still isn't there. And again, the reason this is happening is because SST refresh does not change the resources themselves. It's not going into your AWS console and recreating the Lambda function. All it was doing was it noticed that the Lambda function wasn't there anymore and it updated the state to reflect that. Now to fix this further, I'd have to go in and run a deploy. You'll notice as the deploy completes, it's now created the Lambda function once again. So if I go back into my AWS console and if I search for that function, it's back. If I go into my SST console, it's there as well. In both of these cases, we found a way to diagnose the issue, to figure out what was missing, and use the SST refresh command with the SST deploy command to get it back in sync. But in more complicated situations, it's going to be very hard for you to debug and figure out why things are out of sync, which is why we recommend not modifying your resources directly in your AWS console or through your cloud provider, and instead let the SST config and the SST CLI do it for you.